Today we have with us two members of the cast from Amazon Prime's The Last Hour, the on-screen mother-daughter duo, Raima Sen and Shayali Krissen. Hi Raima, hi Shayali, welcome to Desi Martini.
Hi, hi.
Hi. You know, just the fact that I'll be interviewing you is making me so nervous, Raima.
Thank you.
From the trailer, it looks like you play Sanjay Kapoor's spouse and you have died under mysterious circumstances. So, could you
In the teaser and trailer, I come across as a mysterious character. Sometimes you see her, sometimes you don't. Looks are deceptive. But I'll say that every character in this show has got a very interesting story to them. So even my character, even though she'll be mysterious for a while, I think as the episodes progress, the story behind my character will reveal itself towards the end. So I don't want to like spoil it for the audience if it's releasing it. Yeah. Tomorrow. So for now, let them just think that it's a mysterious, intriguing character. And what is she exactly doing?
Right. Shayali, you play Raima's on-screen daughter who's trying to find answers. So can you give us a hint that where this is going and what it could be leading to?
Yeah, so coming to my character, Pari is a very different than the normal college-going students. And well, that you have to see in the show, what is her connection with Raima's character. I wouldn't say it's a typical mother duo character and things revolving around it. It's something very mysterious. We don't even know if she is my mom or she is not my mom in the show. So coming back to my character, she definitely wants some answers. She definitely is looking for something. She's wondering what she wants, if she will get it, she'll not get it. So yeah, she's a very doubtful character and there's a lot of depth and I'm looking forward to it.
Yes, that was an interesting hint, whether Raima would play your mom or not. I mean, would mean I have been understanding this all wrong since the beginning and I think most of the audiences would as well.
No, so, I'm saying no. I mean, there is much more to it than this, you know, that you actually see in the teaser and trailer. Much more to it. I mean, every time she says, "Ma, my close-up comes," you see, so people get a bit confused. But there is more to it than that.
Okay. So, do you guys share screen space as well? Because, okay, that wasn't visible from the trailer.
We had some scenes. We also had a scene where I had to talk to her photograph, and that's the best scene of my show because I had to look at her photograph and I had to emote some emotions, which normally is very tough when you don't have a dialogue and you just have to speak from your eyes. So I think even her photograph helped me to perform better.
Oh my God. So already there's so much of, this vibe between both of you. I'm really interested to see how it transforms on screen. And Raima, you have been very on and off in the Hindi film industry, though your Bengali filmography is, of course, extraordinary. And thankfully, due to the emergence of OTT, we are seeing you more. So why is that? Why have you been absent from Bollywood?
Okay, I was only absent, I think, for the last 5 years because five years ago, I was getting offers in Bollywood, but they were not something that I was keen on doing, or I didn't feel that they were, you know, my heart was in it. And so I started getting better offers in Calcutta with better directors, better scripts, better roles for me. So I chose to do Bengali films more in the last 5 years. But now with OTT platform and I'm back and being in Bombay. For the last 1.5 years, I've been in Bombay again. And now you'll see me in many more shows. You'll see me in a Tamil film. And hopefully my Hindi film, which I have done back two years back or 1.5 years back, hopefully they'll all release when the theaters open. So you will see more of it for sure.
Okay. We are excited about that and we hope it happens soon. Shaili, one question that I have for you is, how did you get this show? I'm really interested to know that. How did you land up this show?
Yeah, even now I'm thinking, how did I land up in this show? Because all my friends are like, oh, wow, you are on Amazon. But I was approached for an audition and I was in my hometown. So I had recorded something and I sent it to Amit sir. And he liked it and he called me. When I met him, it was a very interesting meeting because, you know, when you meet a director, normally you they have this typical heroine questions to ask you, ki dance kar leti ho, ye kar leti ho, and you know, that typical how a heroine thing has to be there. But he asked me, what do you think about death? I was like, boom, that's a question. But then, you know, the first time you're meeting a director and the director just looks at you and says, tell me something about death. So I was quite you know, surprised, and I felt that he's not a very regular director. And then he and his wife Anupama ma'am, they took my screen test, and I felt very comfortable. I think I was meant for this role. This role came very naturally to me. I am very much like Pari in real. I'm very much always in continuous search of things and doubtful and worried most of the time. You know, so the character is very much similar, and I think the director related to me that wise. And if you see, most of the characters of our show are very real. If you see Sanjay sir's character, he's playing a cop, but he's not playing that Singham cop where he's just shooting, like, you know, he has a beautiful relation which you see with his daughter. He being a cop, he's not able to face his daughter. He's not able to you know, he has that emotions. Every father, there he's not a cop. So I think the whole show, the every character, when you see, it's so real. It will look like they are that character, because I think there is some originality of us in that character. Like for Rama, when you look at her face, she looks very mysterious. You can sometimes see her very innocent, and sometimes you can see her very mysterious, you don't know. So that all is showing on screen because we all are somehow originally little like that. Yeah.
Okay. So, Shaili, how, as you said, like, you shared, you had a scene with Raima's frame, and then you shared, you play Sanjay Kapoor's daughter. There are some of the most talented actors who are a part of this show. So, how was the experience of working with them?
Initially, I was really nervous. Like, I had prepared myself if they asked me what I have to say. And, you know, normally when you are a newcomer and you don't come from a background, you always listen that, you know, people from the industry are not very accept. They don't accept outsiders. Normally, we listen all those things. But it was not like that. I think even though I was playing a on-screen daughter of Sanjay sir, even off-screen he used to treat me like a daughter. Like, he would be like, don't sit like this, don't drink this much tea, it's not good for you, you know, today you're looking like this, you go work out, you know. So those things is something which, you know, only a person who cares for you would say all those things. So it never felt someone, it felt like that Akhya Milao, Akhya Chirao guy just sitting next to me and talking to me, you know. So it was very, very, very nice. And, you know, the first day, the first scene when I did with him, I remember I, even my stylist was like he's of my age. So we both went and we played that Akhya Milao song and we were like dancing on it, you know. Like, these are very precious memories you'll always remember. And then coming to Raima, she was so cool. Like, I have always seen her so beautiful on screen. Like, I'm like, I have told this in all the interviews. Now she's bored listening this, but I should say that I really love her, how beautiful she is. And it was great, you know, to meet her in real. And she is so beautiful. She has no attitude. Like, she's so cool. And then Shahana is a very great actor. She was very, very, very nice and very, I spent most of my time with Shahana, but she was very, she made me very comfortable. So I think, yeah, it was all nice experience. I think people say I'm confident, but I think these all people collectively made me confident. So right. It was a nice experience.
And we can see that excitement when you are speaking about it. And that's even making us excited about the series, you know? So,
yeah.
One thing that Shelley said, continue, please continue.
No. Say, you say.
So one thing that Shelley said was the fact that there's a lot being said about the industry that, newcomers are not welcome. Raima, of course, you come from a background, a very rich filmy background, if I might say so. But also you come from a predominantly regional industry. So coming to, Hindi film industry, did you face any bias, any stereotype or anything of that sort?
Yeah, so initially when I did, my first film was in Hindi, it was Godmother. And yes, I got the first break very easily because it was Gunwan Sen's daughter and because it was Suchitra Sen's granddaughter. And they had come to, Vinay Shukla had come to audition in Calcutta. And he heard of me and I was still studying then. But then I did the film because eventually I knew I was going to join the movies later or sooner. So when I got this opportunity to work with Shabana Azmi and Vinay Shukla, I jumped at it. But then I continued studying. And of course, initially there was a lot of struggle because in Calcutta, they would like compare me with my grandmother. And I thought that was so unfair. I had just done like one or two films. And you know, that comparison was, it was too much of pressure. I think Star Kids also, there's a lot of expectation from them and a lot of pressure to be like their fathers or mothers or grandmothers and grandfathers. So it's very, very tough for them. When a newcomer comes, there's no baggage, there's no family. So then you look at, there's no there's no expectation. But with a Star Kid, I think the expectation starts from your first film. So it was very tough initially and only my first break was easy. After that, I struggled like any other newcomer. I used to go for auditions earlier and then I stopped completely because I've got a phobia and I've been thrown out of 2-3 films and I have struggled like a newcomer. So I don't find the difference that people say nepotism exists and this and that. I don't think so. I think it's the survival of the fittest. And it's up to you how you want, to grow in this journey. It's a tough world out there, but you just have to create your own niche and you have to learn and you have to survive in this industry. And it's all up to you and your struggle. There's no such thing that because I'm a star kid, everything came to me on a platter. In fact, I don't think apart from my first break, anything came to me. I also made an unconventional debut like Godmother. I mean, I didn't do the usual commercial film for starters. Yeah, so for me, it's been a tough journey, but it's been a learning experience. I've got to work with some of the best directors. And just out of like, being there at the right time and, someone just noticing me and saying, will you come? So I've also been very lucky, I would say.
Right. So, my mom was extremely excited that I'll be interacting with you. She's a huge fan and she was like, oh my God, you're interviewing Raima. And she was very excited. This is a question from her, actually. She was asking about how did you deal with the baggage of coming from a filmy background?
Initially, I couldn't understand it. And initially, they would be like, oh, you must learn from your grandmother, learn this from your grandmother. You have choose films like this. So initially, I couldn't understand anything. But I thought there was just too much of pressure. But I think after I did my fifth film, I did Chokir Bali. And I think that broke it. I think after that, I became my own. They noticed me as someone who's her own person, who's Raima Sen. So after Chokir Bali broke all of that for me and then it became smoother. But before Chokir Bali, till I did something which actually got me noticed, it was very, very difficult. You don't understand it when you're so young. But then over the years, now in fact, I love it when they say, oh, you're Suchitra Sen's granddaughter. Now it's become an honor. But earlier it was a pressure to perform like her and it's not possible. But of course, you learn and live and learn and it's your journey and growth and you've got to deal with all of this. It's a part and parcel, I think.
So, with Shelley being a newcomer, what's one advice that you would give to her or have given to her?
No, I think she's, even though she's a newcomer and this is a debut, I think to make this choice to debut in this show, I think it's a very intelligent choice. She's chosen the right show to debut in. She's and I think she's confident. She's natural. she's saying she hasn't learned acting, but neither did I. I'm not a trained actor. But I think you learn along the way with all your directors, all your roles, all your scripts. You just carry on learning. So for me, that's a bigger learning than actually going to a school and, learning. So I think she'll come a long way. She's a natural. She's got great screen presence. In the trailers, you've seen her eyes.
Yes.
And I think doing this show must have taught her a lot. And it will be easy for her, I think, after this. Because she's worked with one of the best directors also. So she must have learned a lot.
Right. So wrapping it up, Prima, Shaili, two reasons why we shouldn't be missing The Last Hour.
First, because it's a very different show on...
You say?
Hello?
Yeah.
First, it's a very different show on Amazon platform. Like, we have seen a lot of love stories and action and drama and all that. But this is a show which is about something which maybe we didn't even read in history about shamans. You know, how many of us know about shamans? So, as an audience, even if I'm not a part of this show and somebody tells me, hey, there is a show which tells you about shamans, so I'll obviously be very curious to know what it is. And we always have thought somewhere that if there is any other life, if beyond this there is any other life. So, you know, in this show, you'll get to know about all those things. You know, at least you'll have a glimpse of it. At least there is a show which is telling you if there is a life which is beyond this life also. So I think that one is a very solid reason to watch it. The second solid reason is that me and Raima are in it. So yeah, that's the two reasons.
I think that the entire team is great. I mean, from Asif Kapadia to Anupama to Amit Kumar. I think the team is great. And behind the camera, and I think in front of the camera also, I think the performances are going to surprise everyone. You see new faces and old faces. And you see faces which you've not seen for many years. But so the performances, the theme, the concept of the supernatural, we learn a lot, and the locations, Northeast, and it's shot beautifully. Yeah, and I think I think all these reasons you should watch.
That's more than two reasons, actually. Thank you so much, Raima. Thank you so much, Shaili.
Thank you
for joining with Desi Martini, and congratulations on The Last Hour.
Thank you.